You know what I normally do? I think long and hard about what I'm trying to say in a vid. I make this full script or I make bullet points and then I just go and do the video. Because you see, a recipe like that can give you great results. It looks professional. It looks quality. You're making sure that you can get the best and accurate information out there. And that recipe has gotten me pretty good success. So today we're gonna be throwing all of that out the window and I'm gonna give you my thoughts on Warframe, my first year with Warframe. Initially I wanted to do this review, this complex review about an hour long, and about halfway in I realized that I'm basically doing what 1,000 other people did and I'm losing the point of the video, which was to relay my thoughts, my legitimate feelings on Warframe. Another reason why I script my vids is that I am not the best person to speak in English. My accent is a bit off and I kind of make a lot of mistakes. So in case I make a mistake, I can go back in, correct it, but not this time. This time we're going full blast. So if this is not your cup of tea, and to be honest, it's not really something that I normally do, you should really tune out now. But for everybody else, about a year ago, give or take a month or so, I was doing Heroes of the Storm content since 2015 and I was pretty burnt out on it, and a lot of my friends kinda noticed that, and the quality in my Heroes of the Storm content was dropping and I knew I needed something else, something to get me excited again, something to get me to put a whole lot of work back into the content. And a lot of the guys were preaching Warframe. Hey, you should give Warframe a try. Try Warframe. And when somebody suggests a game to me, I do what most people do. I head on over to YouTube, I look up a review, maybe I look at some gameplay, and nothing that I saw back then piqued my interest. It seemed awfully mundane, boring, and I didn't see any point to it. But to shut my friends up, I installed the game. It was free to play, so I thought, hey, what's the harm in it, right? I logged in and I started doing the introductory tutorial. Now, the new player experience in Warframe is bad, okay? It's pretty bad. The first couple of minutes were fun because I discovered how dynamic my Excalibur was, because the game allowed me to choose one of three frames. It was Vault, Excal, and I believe Mag, and after a couple of quick questions, I decided to go with Excal because he was the melee guy. Basically, that's what I asked. I remember, hey, is any of these guys melee? And they said, yeah, just go for Excal, he's the melee guy. And I quickly found out that he wasn't very resilient, like, at all. I kept dying and going to the extract point last, but that's not the point. I was hitting every single bloody wall there was to hit, and these guys were dragging me with them on these missions that I didn't understand what was going on. Why am I shooting this guy? Is there any point? Is there? I saw there was loot. Okay, I was excited. Ah, there's loot. I'm gonna get gear. I'm gonna look cool like these guys, because I looked like a goddamn painted potato and they looked like freaking Michael Jackson. I mean, what? Well, okay, fine. There's something I can work to. And this was the first thing that came to mind. I wanna look as cool as these guys. I wanna move as fast as these guys. And I kept logging back into Warframe. And about a couple of weeks passed and I didn't see any point in the game outside of looking good. That was honestly the only point I saw up until that point. I remember one of my earlier vids for Warframe was, where is my endgame? Because I kept asking, hey, where's the endgame? What are we supposed to do? Are there raids? Are there boss fights? Because coming off of a lot of MMOs, I was expecting something like that. Hey, a raid, a boss fight. And it was astonishing to me how many members in the community tippy-toed around this subject. They didn't want to give me a straight answer, honestly. And the more older the players were with Warframe, the more they were tippy-toeing around the subject. And for a while, I left it alone. I was like, yeah, okay, I'll find out by myself, no problem. The more I played Warframe, the more I understood that it's not really about the destination. It's about getting there. It's about the journey. And I'm fully aware that sounds super bloody corny. But the point is, games were supposed to be about fun. That was the basic idea of a game. It still is today. But I guess over time I kind of lost that. Starting playing competitive games where you're supposed to win, 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 and never mind fun and all whatnot. And much to my shame, I kind of lost that. Thankfully, with Warframe, I got it back and I kept logging back into the game without having any real reason. I just wanted to do stuff in Warframe. I wanted to try to exploit all sorts of things, see what my frame was capable of, and I didn't have a goal per se, outside of looking good. Okay, I did want it to look totally badass. Having been a bit fed up with dying all the time, I asked my friends, which were a lot more experienced, what do I need to do not to bloody die all the time? And everybody said, hey, listen, no sweat. You're gonna be dying a whole lot now, but you see, in Warframe, it doesn't really matter, which to me, at that point, did not compute. What do you mean dying doesn't matter? What do you mean? It just goes against everything you are taught. How can you say that? So they kind of gave up and said, okay, let's help you get the Rhino. And I was like, what do you mean, the Rhino? I thought it was some kind of armor, judging by how they looked. He said, no, it's a Warframe. Don't worry, we're gonna get it really quick. And when they said really quick and understanding that this was a new Warframe, I thought, a couple of days farm, easy mode. And I got everything I needed for the Rhino frame in the first 20 minutes of farming. And I was like, wow, awesome. So now I get to make it, right? And then came the crafting system. And I understood that I needed to wait. And then I said something like, oh, look, I can rush it. I just need this plat thing. I had a couple of plat, you know, the starting plat they give you, which is, oh, my God, so not a lot. And everybody yelled at me, no, don't do it. Don't rush it. It's like, why not? I can do it. Well, you're going to need that plat from this and that and et cetera. I didn't listen. I wanted to play that new frame. I wanted to see how it looks, how it acts, what can I do with it. So I rushed the Rhino. Well, part of it, actually, because I didn't have enough plat to rush the whole thing, and by the time it was finished, I was out of plat, so I needed another slot for a Warframe, and I remember one of my friends actually gifting me a slot. I remember I was furious. I was like, what do you mean I can't only have two Warframes, and I need to pay with real money for a third one? Now, everybody did their best at explaining, hey, listen, it's not really like that. You can make plat in the game because you can trade it, and blah, blah. I was still furious. I was still supremely pissed off, and that got only worse in the point when I understood that I needed these Orokin catalysts for my weapons. I wanted to do a whole lot of damage too. I saw the score screen, I saw I was sucking greatly, and these guys were doing basically all of the damage. And my first thought was, well, the weapon is to blame, clearly, since my frame was catered around surviving. I didn't understand much about my frame at the time, and I was using the Rhino, a really shitty painted Rhino. I remember my outrage when I understood I couldn't even use the color black to customize it. There's a lot of customization in Warframe, but you gotta unlock it. And believe it or not, when you start Warframe, the color black is locked. How can you? Why do you even? Honestly, I'm just having fun remembering all this stuff. So I started to build my weapon, and it was a heck shotgun. I love that weapon, honestly, dude. And I started looking up guides, because I didn't know what was the point to the modding. I mean, is this better than that? Should I add heat? Should I add electricity? Why do I not have heat and electricity on my weapon, and I have radiation instead? I couldn't understand much of any, so I started Googling, like what any sane person would do. Now, the guys that I found tried their best to explain what was going on, but I was still mostly clueless, so I ended up looking up a forum and saying, you know what, just copy-paste me a build, just give me a print screen, and I'll just do whatever you did, man, and that's gonna be all great. Of course, I couldn't do that because I didn't have all of the mods, and that was my first journey, to get one gun really, really powerful. I wanted to one-shot higher-level enemies, and to me, high-level back then was level 40-ish, something like that. And I eventually did it. I farmed the mods, I got the endo, these guys, my friends, really helped me a lot with everything I needed, and I was so happy that finally my heck shotgun was one-shotting level 40s. I remember feeling so goddamn proud about it. And then one particular dude said, hey, you know what, let's take him to, I don't remember what mission he said, but it was the Void. I think it was mod back then, to show him some real high level enemies. I was like, yeah, man, let's do it. Show me some actual challenging gameplay, because after I modded my heck, everything seemed rather simple and easy. And of course, being taken to mod on a MR, what was I think it was MR67, no higher than that, with a half modded heck, I believe back then that was the shit. It was actually shit thinking about it now. And of course, I collided with level 60s, 70s, 80s, 100 enemies, which were basically playing with me. I did no damage to them. They were completely destroying me. And I set off at that point to get something that I didn't have. I wanted to understand exactly how to defeat these enemies, how to properly mod my weapon, because these guys were one-shotting them, right? With basically the same gun that I have. I remember complaining, saying, hey, listen, you said this gun was good, but it's not good, because look, I'm trying. And then came the whole theory with how you should mod, how you should do. And a lot of this stuff was mostly self-taught and simply Googling and looking up hours and hours on Wikipedia. I remember I was also outraged by that. I remember feeling, how is it possible that a game doesn't teach you all this stuff? This stuff is nowhere in the game. I'm supposed to alt-tab out and look this stuff up myself. Yes, I know, first world problems, but that's simply how I felt at the time. And bear in mind that even though I had all these complaints about the game, I somehow kept logging back in and playing, which was atypical thinking back at it now. Slowly and surely, I found out how to properly mod weapons, how to properly mod primary and secondary weapons, and I left melee weapons alone in the idea that I will tackle them at some other point, because melee 3.0, believe it or not, a year ago was touted. And everybody told me, hey, listen, don't bother too much with melee right now, because melee 3.0 is gonna come out next weekend, everything's gonna be changed. And I was like, okay, sure. But I was jealous of the dudes that kept spinning around and killing everything. I didn't get that. How are they spinning so fast and everything was dying when I was barely moving on my Rhino? But I still was one-shotting level 40s with my heck. That's when I started doing real content in Warframe, and I think the first video that was appreciated by you guys was my Arcal Plasmor review. And to be honest, when I posted that video, I was so skittish about it because I thought it wasn't really all that good. I thought these guys are gonna pin me to the wall, they're gonna crucify me, because I was used to Heroes of the Storm content, right? And everybody there, back then at least, if you made the tiniest mistake, they would never let you forget it. But in Warframe, I found a totally different community. I found so many players that were willing to invest time and effort into actually explaining and telling you how the game works and what you need and what you should do. I was baffled. I was like, are these guys trolling me? Is this for real right now? What is going on? They were legitimately trying to help. It was amazing. And this is the kind of community that Warframe has. One of the best online communities I have ever encountered. Now, don't get me wrong. Just like any forest has dead weight. But the examples were few and far between. For the most part, the Warframe community is totally gray day. Hats off. And I don't understand, how is that possible? I remember seeing all these bugs in Warframe. I was doing Elite Sanctuary Onslaught. It just came out. And it was so bugged to hell and back. It was barely playable. And I thought myself, I'm gonna look on Reddit. The community is gonna be in an uproar. And that wasn't the case. That wasn't the case. And everybody was telling me, hey, listen, bugs in Warframe? That's normal. I could not believe it that the community was letting the developer get away with something like this. Again, it was something unheard of to me. Who are these guys? How are they getting away with it? And why are these people not saying anything about it? I was baffled by it. I still didn't fully understand it for about half a year until I understood that there's a very special relationship between developer and player base. Basically, the dev has this honest attitude up front, saying like, listen, we don't know everything. If we make a mistake, we're gonna try and fix it. We're gonna hear you out, and we're just gonna try this, and that, and we're not sure exactly what will stick, what won't, how this will work, how that will work, but we're willing to give it a try. And that, to the community, was golden. Okay, they saw that as upfront honesty, which in today's day and age isn't something you get to see a whole lot. So that's the thing. That's why the Warframe community, at that point at least, was so permissive with the developer. And again, to me, that was just like straight off nonsense. It's out of comic books. Seriously, I thought it was a joke, but it wasn't. Now, I thought to myself, I'm never gonna get used to these bugs and I'll never tolerate this nonsense. But once again, I was wrong. The more I played, the more I didn't mind the minor bugs. The more I didn't care about that loading screen on Cetus, okay? Or the fact that my game crashed once and I lost the resources I had. I was like, so what? I can get them back. And so I continued on my way to learn how to properly build stuff in Warframe, how to be efficient, how to deal the most amount of damage, even though there was hardly any point to it. But before I even knew it, I became the guy that was answering the questions. I became the guy that people came to for advice. Should I build this weapon? Should I not build it? I don't have that much endo. What mod should I max first? And I finally understand now, after all this time, what those guys that first taught me felt. It's immensely gratifying, it's immensely satisfying, and I also took a page out of the developer's handbook and I listened to feedback. You guys allowed me to improve my work tenfold easy, so thank you guys for that. There is no point to Warframe, there is no endgame, there is only fun to be had, and fun may be subjective, and that's not gonna be enough for a lot of players. But at the end of the day, wasn't this the whole point to gaming to begin with? There are plenty of things which are suboptimal in Warframe. There are a lot of things that could be improved, but Warframe has that something special. Something that you can't really recreate. There's a whole lot of luck involved into how Warframe turned out. And there's a lot of player feedback as well. The best example would be probably the parkour system that was initially pushed by players doing coptering of all sorts. The developer didn't stomp this out. Instead, they embraced it and made a whole system around it. This whole upfront and honest attitude that they have going on with the community may inspire trust, but it can also be taxing on a personal level. And if you have a look at some of their reactions, you can clearly see that's the case. As long as you give everything you have to your content and you put it out there, then you're essentially putting yourself out there as well. And you know what? It's hard to see your work criticized. I, of all people, should know, and you can't always take it on the chin. But when the going gets tough, well, you guys know the rest of that one, don't you? And I think that's a pretty good note to end on, as I rambled on for quite enough. Thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know in the comment section down below if you enjoy this type of content, or should I never ever do it again. As always, my name has been Lazar, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye bye.